So the first question you want to ask is, what's important to you about, and it might be about your work or your job, about your relationship or whatever. So let's do it in the context of work. So what's important to you about your work? And people will answer with one of five values. Well, it might be the place where I live, it might be the people I work with, it might be the knowledge I'm getting involved in, activities that I get to do, or the things that it provides me. Right? And they're going to answer in that way. And so they might say, well, what's important to you about your work? Well, you know, I get to work with really cool people and do interesting projects. That's people and activities. Or they might say, well, you know, it allows me to buy the kind of car that I want to have and live in the kind of house I want to live in. That's about things. Right? Or they might say, well, it's about all of the stuff I'm getting to learn. You know, I got all these projects. I'm learning all this new stuff, and it's really cool. Right? And so they're going to answer with that answer and give you the clues, right? So they say, well, you know, what's important to me about my work? Well, I really like the people I work with. And then you take that and you ask the next question. And why is that important? Why is that important? And they'll give you one of two answers. It's either about achieving or avoiding. Well, it's, you know, having the right people to work with, you know, just makes my work life so much more enjoyable, you know, and it's a lot of fun and I enjoy going to work. It's all about what I get to achieve. And other people might say, well, you know, I worked in this one environment and I just had a terrible boss and I had terrible coworkers and it was awful. You know, I just hated working like that and I just never want to work like that again. That's about avoiding. So you can ask those questions, what's important about your work? And they'll give you an answer, and you say, well, why is that important? And they'll tell you, well, I like to achieve things, or I want to avoid this other stuff. And then you can start to talk to them in their language. Well, achievers, all you have to do is talk about what they're going to achieve, accomplish, get, benefit from in this work environment. And they'll go, oh, I want to do that. You know, and if they want to avoid things, you have to talk to them in not language. And so you have to say things like, well, you won't have the kind of problems you might have had in the past at other places because we work well together. You know, and you won't have to work all that overtime because we have good processes that allow us to do things in a timely fashion. Right? So we talk about what they won't have to experience that they didn't like. And then we can pace that and lead it towards the benefit of that. But we want to start with how they speak, not how we want to speak about it. If we're an achiever and we talk to an away-from person in our language, they're not going to like us. If we're an away-from person and we talk to an achiever in that language, they're not going to like us. All right? And so if we're hiring people, we want to find people that are going to fit the job that we're looking for. So two simple questions will tell you whether you want to talk about what to achieve or what to avoid. And you're going to use not language with the avoiders. We wouldn't want to do this. We won't have that problem. You know, you won't have to work with these kind of people. You know, you won't have to just stay in the same old job all the time because there's these opportunities that you can move into. Do you get the idea? It's very simple, but it's about connecting with people in a way that's so deep you won't even believe it. All right? So that's the first one, achievers and problem solvers. And problem solvers are good at solving problems, and they're actually good people to hire when you're trying to do Lean and Six Sigma. So that's the first one, achievers and problem solvers. So learn how to use these tools. Be a Moneyball.